Divas, and what's up, Divos? It's your girl, April. So, of course, you know today is Real Talk Wednesday. And being that it is so cloudy and rainy outside, I decided I am just going to wear my turban wrap and look oh so fabulous and cute. So, in case you guys are like, oh, I love the eye look, yes, honeys, yes, there will be a video up this week on this particular eye look. As for the lip color, it is actually from my lipstick line. So, if you girls did not tune in last week, don't follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, and Snapchat, then, of course, you missed out. You didn't really miss out. However, I do have a new lipstick line out that consists of six colors. I said six. I meant to say six colors. And they are matte lipsticks. So, the one that I'm actually wearing is called No Filter, which is this beautiful kind of like peachy coral orange color, and I thought it kind of complemented the eyes. But I will show you the packaging. The packaging does look just like this, bam, and hopefully it will show up on camera. If not, of course I will post a picture and or insert a picture, but it does look like that. And as for the actual casing, just like that. So the one that I'm actually holding is called Moved On. And yes, I think that's the one I actually have on my lips, actually. Yeah. No. So yes, each one of these six lipsticks are sold on GuruGlammakeup.com, and I will post it below. I was able to choose all my colors, as well as that the formulas, they are very moisturizing to your lips, so they don't dry out like most matte lipsticks do. They actually feel like a lip balm, and that was the one thing that kind of like freaked me out, because I'm like, oh my god, they just feel so like moist, they're probably not going to be matte. And that's what I started thinking, but they actually feel like they act like a lip balm. So yes, so each one of them has a particular name, which I named myself. Along with that, the colors that I chose, which are more or less very bold and springy colors, but of course you can wear some of them into the fall. So yes, go ahead and support your girl. Check out the link below for my lipstick line. Like I said, there's six colors, and real quick I'm going to show you the swatches. So this one is Moved On, and it's more or less kind of like an orangey color. And then we have Tinky, which is named after my grandson. In case you want to know what Moved On stands for, well, of course, I moved on to Arizona, West Coast to the East Coast. Tinky is my grandson, which is like this very bright fuchsia color pink. Smooches, which is named after my very first website, which is my jewelry website. And also, I used to say smooches at the end of all of my videos on my first channel, which is more or less this reddish color right here. You know, when you show pictures of lips and smooches, they have to be red. This one here is Gemini, which is who I am. This is my zodiac sign. And if you girls know me really well, then you know that I love like really light pale lips. So yes, that is this color right here. I love like very light pale lips. That is like my signature color, okay? This one is Sweetums, which is my very first grandson. And for those of you like my girl Shay who love purples, then this one would be perfect for those lips. Oh, and it is raining outside. And the last but not least is No Filter, which of course I am wearing right now. And I think like this color is perfect because it's between, like I said, a peachy and a coral color. And it's very like very pretty and shocking. And like me, I'm very pretty and shocking, but I don't really have a filter. And my kids are constantly saying that I just am non-filtered. So yes, that is this color right here. Unfortunately, they're kind of looking the same. Well, you can't tell the color offhand, but you can see the color on my lips, which is perfect. So yes, that is my lipstick line. I'll post all the information below so that way you guys can go and check it out and spend your money on it, okay? But anyway, other than that, as for life goals or life situations, let me tell you. You guys know that I purchased a new dog, which is Sugar. She was from the Halo Shelter, $25, mini poodle. Love her to death, went all out with, you know, accessories or clothing for her, what have you. Okay, but here's the thing. I've already had a dog, Coco, who was 10. Sugar is 8. Why does she not get the fact that you cannot go in my dining room and shit and piss on my rug? Like, my dog does not do that. She will not get off the furniture. She is just not getting it. And I am so tired of cleaning up this pee and shit. Last night, you know, I'm constantly checking. She loves to go outside, but it's so funny and weird that I think she feels like she's just too cute to shit and pee outside. And I don't know why, but let me tell you something. You're going to have to follow suit and go along with the home team, okay? Because for one, I don't like a dirty home. I'm not about to have my house smell like a dirty pet. And I put her in a cage and stuff to punish her because that's what you're supposed to do. But you know what? I've had my dog for 10 years and he always follows suit. So he is part of the home team. Coco knows the rules. He knows the deal. She's just not getting it and I'm not really sure what to do. But here's the thing. Everybody in my house, we know the deal. We are the home team. You're going to have to follow suit and follow the home team and go with what you know and what we do here. There ain't going to be none of that. And I hate to feel this way about an animal because I love to rescue anyone. I love to help anyone. But after a while, certain things really start to get to me. And that is really starting to get to me. So like I've been saying, I have been checking in this certain spot for days. And it was clear, clean, nothing. So I stopped checking for like 2 days. Why did Tati tell me last night, oh, Sugar then went to the bathroom in your dining room? She not went once. This bitch done went like 4 times in my bathroom, in my dining room. Like it's her own little personal litter box. Yeah, so yeah, even though she's a small dog, her shit is like this size. But still, we cannot do this. And I just have my rugs clean. And my dining room area does not have high traffic, so those rugs constantly stay looking like they're brand new. I had a fit and had to put her in her cage. And first of all, when you are disciplining an animal when they use the bathroom in your house, you have to put their nose in it and whack them a couple of times with the newspaper or rolls of magazine and either put them outside or put them in the cage. She just came from outside, so I had to put her in a cage overnight. I'm not really sure why she don't think that she don't have to use the bathroom outside, but here's the thing. You either gonna follow suit and follow the home team, because we all know the rules up in here, including Coco. He know what time it is. Like when he know not to beg me for no food. He know not to beg in the kitchen. He knows the deal. And when he do things that I don't feel is appropriate, I be just like, bye Felicia, bye. And he knows what bye Felicia, bye me and leave. He don't get on my furniture, you know what I'm saying? He don't beg and he don't follow me around when I have food. She is the total opposite. So I'm really trying to train her. Really, really trying hard. But she just don't know what bye Felicia mean. And or the finger, like when I'm pointing to go. This, my dog, he, you know what I'm saying, Coco knows. He been around for 10 years, so he like, oh, bitch, I'm part of the crew. I already know. When this bitch be uptight, he know how I am. So it's really starting to irritate me right about now. Like, you're going to have to follow the rules or I'm going to have to give you away to a loving family. I'm a loving family, but I'm not going to continuously clean my goddamn rug. Okay? That's not going to happen. You know what I'm saying? What if my grandson would have went over there and picked up one of those turds? That would have not been cool. You know what I'm saying? So I was just really, really upset about the whole situation. And in case you guys wondering, the update on Sugar, that's the update. Okay, and the update is April ain't too happy about the shit, all right? The shit, the piss, none of that shit. Like, I don't get down like that. We don't get down like that here. So she better just follow suit. Other thing, also, so I decided to do more family vlogs on my family, because we are just a little bit crazy sometimes. You just don't get to see that on camera because you just see me normally sitting here and doing like beauty vlogs and shit like that. So we had to come up with a name for our family vlog. So I was like, Tati, when she replies to smart ass messages like comments on my YouTube channel or whatever, dumb bitches on Facebook saying smart shit, she be like, oh, you trying to keep up with the Furmans, right? Because you know that's the last name. Keep up with the Furmans, like keeping up with the Kardashians. So I was like, well, I'm gonna call it keeping up with the Furmans. She was like, no. She was like, okay. So then she's like, what about keeping up with the muffins? Because I'm a big muffin and they're my little bite-sized muffins. And I was like, okay, but I don't really want to get sued and I don't really want them to be like, oh, they just bit off of our keeping up with. So then Tati goes, muffins baskets. I was like, first of all, why is it all plural? Muffins, baskets? We're a pastry show now? I don't want people thinking I'm cooking and shit. And it was just weird. So, of course, I video recorded that portion of our family vlog. And so, mainly my vlogs are done with my Samsung Galaxy 7, which is a really great quality camera, and it was much better than me having to go out and spend money on buying a camera. So yes, I love this camera. Thanks to my phone company for sending me this camera, I mean this phone, you know what I'm saying, free of charge. So yes, so thank you for that. So I decided to call it Hanging Out with the Muffins. Okay, so I don't really know. What would you guys call it? I mean, my daughter's like, we're not all Furmans. We're not all Furmans, which is true, but they ain't all Kardashians neither. But either way, here nor there, it is what it is. So if you guys have a name title, let me know what y'all would, what you guys would call it. And I'm not really sure if I want to do a separate channel. You know what I'm saying? I'm not really sure. Because some people put up daily vlogs every day, but I have so much shit to put up every fucking day. So it's like, yeah, I don't think so. Okay. But so let's get on to this real talk. If you have a real talk situation that you need advice on, you can always send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. And please make sure to put in the subject line real talk. And if you want to change the name of anyone in your emails, please make sure to disclose that in the email as well. So on to that, let's get on to this real talk, y'all, because I think I blabbered on just about enough, right? Okay, you guys, so I'm trying to make these shorter because when I first started doing real talk again, it was only one video, so it was like 15-20 minutes. Then I started doing two to catch up, then it started being three to catch up because I started getting the flood of emails. So now these end up being like an hour long, and I really don't want to do like hour long real talks because I have so much to do in a day. Like I said before, 24 hours in a day, and I used up like 18 of them. You know what I'm saying? I'm super busy. So anyway, my name is Joy, age 31, and I have been in a relationship with a man, Brian, age 42, for a little over a year, and I have lived with him for half that time. So here's the situation. Brian is a decent guy and has a good job, but lately I think it might be time to move on. He has three kids, ages 14, 7, and 4, and all of them act a fool. His daughter, whom he has custody of, is the oldest, and the other two kids are boys. His daughter whom he has custody of is the oldest, the 14-year-old, and the other two kids are boys. His daughter Tiana comes and goes as she pleases and is very disrespectful. She's disrespectful to her dad, not me, but she only talks to me to ask for money or to buy her food. And I don't play that, so I tell her no. I have tried to talk to her about her behavior, but she didn't give a damn about what I was saying, so I said fuck it. The boys jump off the couch, bounce off the walls, and try to listen to grown-up folks' conversation so they can go back to their mom with the info. I spoke to Brian about their behavior, and he even says they act like animals, but that they're just kids. I hate that he says that because I believe you get that behavior together when they are young, not when they are when they get old. Damn, it's raining. When we first met, he acted like he was looking for a wife and wouldn't mind having another child since he knows I don't have any. Now this fool doesn't mention it, and I feel like he's on some bullshit and even said he doesn't want any more kids. I told him, you know I don't have kids and I want at least one, but it's a topic he doesn't want to talk about. Also, he let a guy move in with us and he didn't even ask me, just told me that his friend of the family needs help and will be there in a couple of days. I was pissed. Girl, the guy been here about 2 months now and I'm not very friendly to him because he's ungrateful, and I'm like, you living here free, the fuck you acting like that for? Brian and I have argued over that several times. I have had a bachelor's degree almost 2 years and have not found a job in my field. But here I put in a few apps in Arizona and I've gotten callbacks. I believe it's a sign. I should leave because nothing's going on here and my relationship is turning sour. Should I leave and start a new life or try to work it out with Brian? P.S. I'm afraid I won't meet a good guy and might not ever have a child. Thanks, Joy. First of all, let me go roll up my windows because it is like pouring rain outside, okay? Okay, so, oh my God, it is pouring freaking rain outside and my windows was down. Okay, so anyway, so Joy is 31 and she's been with this guy, Brian, for a little over a year, who's 42 years old. Now, first of all, Brian has three kids, 14, 7, and 4, and the 14-year-old girl is a girl. The 14-year-old is the one he has custody of, who is a girl, and obviously lives at home with her and Brian. So she's disrespectful, and she's not disrespectful to Joy, but she will ask her for shit, and that ain't cool. Then the other two that are 7 and 4, they boys, so when they do come over, they in business of the grown folks. They jumping off the couch, they acting crazy and going back and telling their mother what's going on. And on top of that, Brian then has somebody, one of his friends, move in who's been living there for a few months. The guy is ungrateful, ain't got no respect, and don't pay to fucking live there. And she's like tired of it. Basically, she's tired of it. Brian ain't talking about getting married no more. Brian ain't talking about no kids. She can't seem to get a good job where she's at. She's been putting applications out here in the AZ, and she's been getting callbacks. So she's wondering, should she just move on or try to work it out with Brian? Here's my thing. First of all, y'all been together a little bit over a year. I'm sorry, but I wouldn't even be living with his punk ass after a year, okay? Especially if it's somebody that you just met. He's kind of like older than you, 11 years older than you, which is really no big thing, but he got kids. And that's one thing that I don't do really well with. Even though I have my own kids, I don't really want to live with somebody who got their own kids, okay? Because they just be acting real funny style with their kids, and I'm not with all of that funny style shit. Second of all, now he done moved somebody else in, so y'all got a roommate and shit too? Like, it ain't hard enough with two adults and a teenager and some motherfucking kids coming over, but now y'all got a roommate who is ungrateful and ain't even paying to live there. So you paying his roommate's portion of the bill. Because if you think about it, if there's three people living there, that shit should be cut three ways. But however, the guy is staying there rent free, food free, electricity free, cable free, water bill free, whatever else the fuck free up in that motherfucker. But you footing the bill. And you gonna ask me, should you stick it out with Brian? Now, because he ain't been talking about having no more kids and getting married. It's only a year, a little bit over a year. I don't really think y'all should be talking about having no kids after no year. Y'all ain't been together long enough for all of that. A year is still getting to know a person because you start knowing their flaws and shit and find out that they really fake and shit. You see that their representative is no longer available, but the real them has came out of the woodworks. So a year is still time to get to know somebody, and that's when you figure out like, I don't want to have a kid with you. I don't even want to look at you. Better yet, I don't even want you breathing in the same fucking air, in the same apartment house, living complex, wherever with me, okay? Don't even let me catch your ass in the store. Seriously? So, yeah, a year is you still getting to know a person. So, I'm just saying. And getting married, listen, I got to be married. I got to be with you longer than a year to get married. For some people, that just ain't the case. But for people like myself who have been through marriage and have already been through shit like that, we already know. Like, listen, I am really not trying to be married to nobody. Never, ever again. It's just a piece of paper. Second of all, here is the thing. Your ass is not the same ass that I remember from a year ago. You, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde have came in and took it over. And I'ma need you to go back to the way, I'ma need you to revert back to the way your ass was. Or I'ma just leave your bitch ass in the ditch, okay? I'ma leave that bitch in the ditch. Now you wanna know whether you should try to work it out with him or move on because you have been getting messages from Arizona regarding jobs because you got a bachelor's degree. Let me tell you something. It's always great to try to work out a relationship, but if it's not going to work itself out, then it's not going to work out. You and him have total different morals and values about raising children, obviously. Why would you want to have a child with somebody who says, oh, they're just kids? Just because they are children does not give them the right to jump the fuck off furniture, act crazy, and act wild. And if he is the first to admit, yeah, they're crazy and wild, and they act up, but they just kids, that does not give him an excuse or them kids an excuse to act the way they do. If you continuously allow these little motherfuckers to act like little motherfuckers, they will grow up to be big motherfuckers and be the ones in shackles and handcuffs at the fucking jail and the court system, okay? So those are the type of motherfuckers that you really don't want to raise. So what they are kids, that is when you teach them not to act like a bunch of wild aliens, okay? That's not an excuse because they are 4 and 7. And at the age of 4 and 7, I think you should know better than jumping on somebody's goddamn furniture, okay? You teach them that at like the age of 1, 1.5, 2, don't jump on my goddamn furniture, you little motherfucker, okay? Because if you do, I'ma whip your ass and you won't have no legs to stand on. That's just what you teach your kids at certain ages. You don't start teaching them at 4 and 7. Don't jump on the furniture, Bobby, Sue, and Michael. Don't do that.
they're just kids, you know. They just act like that because they're just kids. But, you know, yes, they ride on the walls too, but he's only 7 and a half. He won't be 8 until next, like, 6 months. So, you know, it's okay. He's just a baby still. You know, yes, I know that he just wrote on your wall too, but they just kids. You know what I'm saying? They're just kids. I wish a motherfucker would bring their goddamn kids to my house and they start jumping on my goddamn furniture, because I will let you know and your kids know, if your little motherfucking kid don't stop jumping on my furniture, I'm gonna break their legs, and then they not gonna be jumping nowhere again in life. That's why people that got kids don't come to my house, all right? Especially some badass motherfucking kids. I do not like no bad kids. However, all the people that I know, the little bit of friends that I have, their kids are grown. And my kids know, you're not going to go to nobody's house and be disrespectful. Don't ask for shit. Don't look for shit. Say hello, miss and ma'am. Do not act fucking. Don't embarrass me. All right? Don't embarrass me. So y'all got two different moral values on having kids and raising kids. So therefore, that's just not going to work out for you guys. And should you move on? Sweetheart, it's only been a year. You got to know him in that year. You got to actually know that he's an asshole and he's not the type of person that you would want to spend your time with. And his kids are a bunch of fucking wild aliens that you can no longer tolerate. And if he is allowing his 14-year-old daughter to come and go as she pleases, and she's only 14, I can only imagine what she's going to be like when she's 16 and 17. Probably some loosey-goosey young teenager who's just don't give a fuck about life or respect anybody, okay? But he allows her to be disrespectful, and he allows her to do whatever. So therefore, that is the type of person who I would not really want to share my life with, nor have children with. And you know what? Don't be afraid that you won't find a guy, regardless in life. Because eventually, the right one is going to come along. Me, particularly. I just left it alone and decided, you know what, the right gentleman caller will come into play, whether he do or he don't. Right now is my time to shine. Right now is my time to get my shit together and go for my goals in life. And some men just cannot appreciate that. And some men, it's kind of like a conflict with. Some men just don't do well with women who are on the internet, just like the white guy that I was dating. He didn't have a Facebook, he didn't have an Instagram, he didn't have any type of social media platform. And then when he did see my YouTube channel, it kind of took him by surprise. He just wasn't used to it. So, and your microwave took me by surprise. But some men just are not able to accept the fact that I am who I am and I'm just going to be this way regardless, you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to change for a man. And I may change somewhat, but not change who I am and change my personality. So I just feel like it's best for me to just be me and just to deal with what I need to deal with and get ahead in life. Now, as for you, I feel the same way. If you have job offerings out here in Arizona and you can find a better life, then go for it. You see me, I've left the state and went ahead and moved on. And that's what I would think that would be the best situation. You cannot hold your career and your life goals back for a man, especially if he doesn't want to change and he's not really trying to support you in your decision to do such, as well as even with children. Your time for children will come along. But right now, I think that it's best that you go ahead, take that lead in life, and get yourself your job that you well deserve and work for. And you never know, coming to Arizona may be the perfect move for you, and you may find the gentleman caller that you've been seeking. Maybe one that wants to have children, because I see a lot of motherfucking bitches out here walking around pregnant all day, every day. So you might just be one of them. So let her know what you think about her situation. What would y'all do? Like, that's just my personal opinion, and that's just how I feel about it. Okay, so the next one is more or less like a long distance relationship, and this is pretty damn long. Hi April, I've been loving your channel and look forward to your real talk videos. Although some of your words are harsh, you speak the truth, and I really need to hear your opinions on this matter. I have nobody else to talk to about this, so I am turning to you for help. You can call me Sarah. I'm 21 years old, currently living in Europe. I have been in a long-distance relationship for 7 years with a guy who lives in the U.S. Please don't judge me. Let's call him James. Because of the distance and our age, James and I aren't able to meet as often as we'd like because the airfare is very expensive and other bill payments come first, of course. James has went to college but hasn't really completed any of it because he doesn't know what to do with his life. So he works full-time in a fast food restaurant but is looking for other work he could do. James is 24. I attended college, but not the usual 3-year course, but as a year-long course that has allowed me to be trained in the field I want to work. Because I'm 21, not yet working in the field, I work in a terrible call center job and want to quit, but I need the money, so I stay. After seeing James a month ago when I went over to the U.S. to see him, I was so upset that we had to say goodbye yet again. But we're already planning to meet next summer and travel around Europe while he visits me. After leaving to come back home, I was emotional for a few days and felt very depressed as I just had to leave the man I love behind. So since then, we have been talking about marriage. Now, my plans was to get married a little later on in life, but because of our situation, there aren't many ways we can be together otherwise. If he wanted to come live here, he'd need a job sponsor and a job that pays at least $30,000 per year. If I went over to the U.S., I'd need company to sponsor me as well, and the process is complicated. I don't really want to live in the U.S., and the concept scares me. Even the rules and how some people are, it's just too alien for me to want to move there. I enjoy living in Europe, and James seems to like it as well, as he says things make sense here. So now the wedding. We are planning the engagement in a year from now when he visits me, and then a year later get married. Nothing has happened yet, but I'm already stressing out about everything. I get along so well with his family, and his mom is fantastic. She enjoys talking to me, always takes interest in me, and his whole family is just so welcoming to me. I'm sure if we got engaged, they'd be thrilled. Now, my family is different. My family doesn't approve of my relationship at all. And my sister, who's 33, a few times she has been telling me to break up with James. I don't even have much family here apart from my sister. I had a falling out with my mom, but my sister recently has been in contact with her, trying to save whatever mother or daughter relationship there could be. My mother never liked James either. If I got engaged, I feel my family would make silly and rude comments my way. I am nervous of their opinion, and their opinion matters because they are my family, and after all, none of my extended family, like aunts or cousins, are close to me. All I have is my sister and my mom, and I haven't spoken to her since I was 18. My sister got married when she was 20 because at 19 she had my nephew, so she shouldn't really be commenting on anything. Another thing with the wedding is the cost and who will travel here and who will come. Like I said, realistically, I only have my sister, her two kids, and maybe my mother. Two friends I could invite as well. My social circle of friends I'd invite is small. We have discussed getting married where I live, but the issue is he is closer to his family than I am. He has his both parents and their spouses, his grandparents and cousins, and he'd want to attend the wedding. Now, because the tickets cost anywhere from $800 to $1,500, I don't know who would spend that kind of money to come to a destination wedding like that. I can maybe marry in the U.S., but I am responsible for paying my sister's ticket. And should I even invite my mother for the wedding, though she disapproved? I'd be worried if she would start some drama. If we got married in the U.S., then I'm sure my sister would end up coming with her two children, and that's all I would have there. James would have his whole family, aunts, uncles, grandparents, and I would have nobody. Though his family loves me and is happy to see and talk to me, I still feel it would be so odd to have so few people at my own wedding being from my side. Not that I have ever dreamed of a huge wedding, but it would be nice to have more than three people from my side to come. I really don't know what to do, but I have a plan. But I have to plan some things now just to estimate costs to know how much to save. I don't think my sister would help with the wedding in any way in regards cost. Maybe his family would a little, but I don't expect them to at all. April, please help me as soon as I don't know what to do. XOXO Sarah. So Sarah is 21 and she is living in Europe and she's been in a long distance relationship with, I think his name is James, for 7 years, who lives in the U.S. Okay, and he's 24. Okay, they both work at jobs that they really don't care for. They don't get to see each other like that. Sarah does not speak to her mom. Sarah has not too many family members that she's connected with like that. And James, on the other hand, does. Now they're planning a wedding. She doesn't know where to have the wedding. She's confused as to where she should invite his family to Europe to get married and make it a destination wedding. And the tickets can cost anywhere from $800 to $1,500 per person. And I'm thinking this is round trip. I'm not really sure. I would hope it was round trip. And et cetera, et cetera. And she doesn't know if she goes and gets married in the U.S. Should she invite her mother because she doesn't want her mother to cause drama, and she doesn't really want to get married in the U.S. because she really doesn't have that much family, and she's scared. Listen, first of all, it's nice to have big stuff, big weddings, big destination this, big destination that, but some people go all out a little bit too much on certain materialistic things just to please other people. Listen, when I started planning my first wedding, which was with my ex-husband, we were going to have this huge wedding. We bought the dresses. I bought my dress. I bought a couple of the bridesmaids' gowns. Then I started having to plan certain things. And then me and his mother wasn't getting along. She was saying her certain little snide comments, and his sister as well. My mother was like, oh, I'm not coming. And even though we lived upstate New York and my mother lived in New York City, she didn't want to come. She didn't want to travel. It just started becoming really annoying. And then we started figuring out, you know what? I don't even want to get married. I don't want to get married. And we just kind of like blew the whole thing off, just decided not to do it. So I was stuck with all these like kind of like invitations and things that I was going to DIY. I was also stuck with my wedding gown and a few of the bridesmaids' gowns as well. And we kind of like broke up for a few months. I put him out because he said he didn't want to do this no more with the wedding. And I felt like, wow, you're listening to your mom, because she said, why do you want to marry her? She has kids prior to your daughter. You know what I'm saying? So it started feeling like a big task, and I started feeling like, you know what, you're going to listen to her, then you just go ahead. So we broke up for a couple of months, or I broke it up with him, and he went back to live with his mother, and I was fine with that. And then we finally got back together, and which was only like a couple of months, and we decided to take a vacation. And our vacation was in Walt Disney World, okay? So that was in Florida. And you know who was at our wedding in Florida, Walt Disney World? Me, him, my eldest son, Jerron, my eldest daughter, Tati, my middle son, Wuzzle, and me and my ex-husband's daughter, who was two at the time. It was just us, okay? It was just us. My mother, she knew about it after we got married. Everybody knew about it after we got married. We let everybody know. We were on vacation for over 2.5 weeks. We had rented a home, and we enjoyed every bit of it without anybody being at our wedding, because it was done for us, okay? It was not done for the speculations of family and oohs and ahs. It was done for us. And sometimes when you do things for other people, it interferes with what you want to happen. Okay, and that's what happened with us. It interfered with what we wanted to do. We wanted to do a wedding for everybody else, and it interfered. We went along with what people were saying. Oh, I'm not gonna come, and this and this and that. You don't come. You don't want to come to your own family member's wedding. I'm not gonna sit here and rack my brain. And at the time, I really didn't have too many friends either. Still don't. But there was really nobody for me to invite. So it was like, you know what? I'm not gonna do this for these people. This is what we want to do, and we're going to do this for us. So in reality, what I'm trying to say is, stop trying to please everybody. You don't have to get married to show off and to do it for other people. You get married for yourself. And if nobody don't fucking show up, so what? Are you going to live with these people for the rest of your life? Who are you going to lay in bed with every night? Who are you going to have children with, have sex with, cook dinner with, go on vacations with, share your life with? Not them. When the wedding is over, these people don't give a fuck about what you done did today. They're probably gonna talk about you. Did you see what she had on? Oh, did you see her mascara? Did you see that dress? I wouldn't have wore that to my wedding. Bitch, you never even got married. Don't nobody even want to marry you. You don't even got a man. What the fuck? And it's the same thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, we got married with nobody around but our children, and that was enough for us. And it was informal. But it was no fanciness. My wedding dress was not even with me in Florida, okay? It was at home in New York. We wore nice outfits. And you know something? That was the best freaking day of our lives. And I look back and I say that now because we was really, really happy then. And that was back in 2004. And unfortunately, shit doesn't work out all the time and you end up getting divorced. But we were so happy, you know what I'm saying? And after we got married, we went to Animal Kingdom and we took a tour. We got on one of the rides and we went on a tour as a family. Oh my God, my lashes. And We went back to our house rental because we rented a house in like this great subdivision, gated subdivision, and we barbecued, and we had a big pool, we went swimming, and we did all of these things for 2.5 weeks, you know what I'm saying? And we did it for us. We didn't give a fuck about impressing nobody, because impressing people, it does not impress my pockets. You know what I'm saying? It was much cheaper, and it was much more love-oriented than worried about what this person is going to want and what that person is going to want. Your wedding is to please you. Fuck a destination wedding. I guess our wedding was a destination wedding, but it was just the two of us. And sometimes, just like the song says, just the two of us. We can make it if we try, just the two of us. You and I, you got to think about just the two of you guys. Fuck everybody else around you, because some people's inputs is not what you want to hear, and it's not worthy. You know what I'm saying? And other people's inputs will fuck up your day and even your pockets and your situations. So to me, your email was long, but my response is much shorter. Stop worrying about what everybody else thinks. Stop worrying about what everybody else wants. Stop worrying about what you're trying to impress and doing shit for other people. You do shit for you. You know what I'm saying? Your pockets ain't even fat enough to go back and forth. So what you worrying about some wedding for? You guys, when he comes to Europe, you guys go and elope and get married together and do it for the two of you guys. You know what I'm saying? Not for anybody else. Not for no speculations. Not for no views. Not for no shit like that. You do the shit because you love the person, and that's who you want to do it for. If you can't do it for that, then there's no reason to do it at all. Bottom line. So let her know what you think about that, Sarah. Okay? Okay, my love. So this is going to be the last one. The last video. Or the last real talk. Dear April, I have already changed the names. You can call me Mercedes. I am 25 years old and I work part-time as a housekeeper at a nursing home. In November, something crazy happened to me. I was dating this guy, Kenneth, for about 6 months and I really loved him. But then he started to steal money from me and he beat me up a few times and the fights just kept getting worse. Till in November, I had had enough. We got into a fight and I slapped him first because he said something disrespectful. And after that, I was on the ground getting stomped. He kept kicking me and punching me, and his mom could barely get him off of me. And her boyfriend acted as if he was scared himself. And it didn't really help, and he didn't really help me. Then he stopped for a second, and I locked myself in this room. I heard him yelling outside the door, y'all can't save her. Something told me to look for a window. The first one didn't open, but the second one did, and he started kicking the door. Boom, it fell to the ground and I went to jump out the window, and as I was falling, somehow he caught me by my hair and basically bashed my face up against the house, then finally dropped me. And as soon as I hit the ground, I was moaning, but something told me to get the fuck up now. And I got up and ran down the street to a friend's house, and this is in Wisconsin. So it was ice cold and I had no coat on and one shoe. My friend called 911 for me and I was taken to the hospital. And there were 5 officers in my room asking me the same questions over and over and over again. And I pointed his picture out and told them what happened. The DA never called me, shaking my head. To make a long story shorter, my hours at work decreased and I lost my apartment. And I ignored his calls because I had a pinched nerve in my leg, and it caused something called foot drop, where your foot is basically paralyzed. He did this to me, and I never received justice. It took 3 months for my injuries to heal, and I still get off balance sometimes. Now I've been diagnosed with PTSD, and everyone is telling me to get help for it. So I'm working on meeting with a therapist soon, because I'm tired of the nightmares of people trying to kill me and the paranoia. So how would you deal with it if this was you? Would you go to therapy? Also, I admire you, and I want to make YouTube videos also. My dream is to have my own business, like how I see you're doing, starting with a dog animal daycare facility. Nice. How should I go about making my goals come true? What steps should I take? And thank you for reading my letter. I love your videos. If you want to see my pic, keep this private, but look me up on Facebook under... Okay. So basically, Mercedes is 25 years old. She's a part-time housekeeper at our nursing home. She done had her battle with some fucking crazy-ass dude who was stealing for her and beat the crap out of her on numerous occasions. Basically, she has been traumatized and she wants to know how to get over it. Would she go to therapy? And also, how does she reach her goals in life and how to start her own business? So here's the thing. First of all, sweetheart, you should have been knew when that nigga started stealing from you that he wasn't the type of dude that you wanted to fuck with. I'm sorry, but I'm not about to let no fucking loser steal from me. I don't give a fuck what it is. Steal my heart, steal my fucking food. You ain't about to steal shit up in this bitch, okay? Second of all, the first fight y'all had should have been the first and the last fight. Okay, because it don't get no better. They apologize and they be like, oh, I'm so sorry, girl, it won't never happen again. It won't never happen again like this, because the next time it happens, it's gonna get a million times worse. That's what the fuck they mean. It won't never happen again like this. The next time it happens, I'm gonna really beat the shit out of you, and so on and so on. And that's how the fuck it is, you know what I'm saying? It's so sad that men could go around and put their hands on a female. Those are the type of dudes that really just need to get fucked up. You know what I'm saying? Like, get your brother, your uncle, or whoever to fuck they ass the fuck up on some realness. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, because a bitch like me, you put your hands on nigga, you gonna have a fight on your hands. You gonna be the one that's gonna need to go to the hospital. Not my black ass, because by the time I get finished with you, I'm gonna fuck you up, and then I'm gonna go get my sons to fuck you up. Then I'm gonna call my two brothers to fuck your ass up. And whoever else male figure I got in my life, they gonna fuck your ass up. So you gonna wish you never even knew a bitch like me. But you know what? Some people, it's just a hard lesson learned. They just take it as, he loved me, or it's just the first time, it won't happen again. Dead wrong, okay? Now, what makes it so bad is this disrespectful bastard beating you up in front of his own mother. If this nigga could do this in front of his own family members, then he don't have no coof at all. You know what I'm saying? He ain't got no respect for nobody. He ain't got no respect for himself if he could do some shit like that. Real shit. If a nigga could beat you up in front of their mother, then he ain't got no respect. Dead ass. Because you his mother. I'm just saying. Now you've been scarred for life, basically, and you wondering if you should go to therapy. Therapy is good for some people. I mean, I've been through a lot of shit in my lifetime, and I've never went through therapy. However, I just give my own self therapy, and I just say, you know what, I'm not gonna deal with this shit no more. I'm not putting up with this shit no more. And I just seclude myself from a lot of bullshit, and I just basically get into my work and get shit done. And that's what the fuck I be doing. This is just what I be doing. But other people need an outlet. Some people need somebody to talk to, and that's fine. If it's gonna make you feel better and it's gonna make your life better, then why not do it? So it all depends on the person if you need therapy or not. You know what I'm saying? You can't come to me and ask me, do you need therapy and should you take therapy, from someone who has never done therapy. You know what I'm saying? I'm just not really okay with sitting there and talking to somebody who gets paid for that shit to tell me what the fuck I want to hear, or you think I may want to hear, or you think that you getting paid to tell me what the fuck I want to hear. I'm just really not cool with that. Me, honestly, I would really want to go to someone who's supposed to be a real friend. And a real friend is like my friend Shay, who I've like told y'all about. When I tell her some shit that I've done, she don't agree to what I do. A real friend is someone who will tell you, bitch, you stupid, or you dead wrong, leave that nigga alone, what the fuck is wrong with you? That is what a real friend is. You know what I'm saying? Those are real friends who give their unbiased opinion and are able to tell you what you really should do, not what the fuck you want to hear. You ain't got to pay they ass. You know what I'm saying? Not a family member or whatever. Sometimes a family member is cool, but me personally, I'm not about to pay somebody for therapy for you to tell me that, oh, this is what you need to do to make you feel better. However, sometimes a therapist is good because you just may need certain type of medications that may help your fucking ass calm the fuck down. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes we all need that. I need medication sometimes, okay? I need my own shit to calm down. However, I don't need to go to a doctor to get a prescription. I could just hit my bong up and I'm good to go. Maybe you should try that shit. That should make you feel real good, okay? But either here nor there, it depends on you as a person. If therapy is what you want to try, then give it a shot. You can never knock something until you try it. Just like what the people would say, girl, why are you moving to Arizona? Why are you moving all the way on the West Coast? Oh, you crazy. You stupid. And I almost listened to that shit, okay? And here it is 3 years later. 3 years later, and I fucking love it. And you couldn't drag me from this side of the world, okay? I've had enough of y'all motherfuckers in my business on the East Coast, so now I'm gonna give motherfuckers on the West Coast some time to get up in my business, okay? On some real shit. But I don't really know what's going on with my camera. It just stops recording, and the memory card is not full. Like I was saying, if you have an issue, then you have to work around it and do what you see fit for your own self, not what others feel see fit for you. However, the part about your goals in life and how do you reach your goals, if it's a goal, it's a goal. You have to do what you feel is best in life. If you want to be a bum and that's what you want to do in life, then be a bum. However, me, you know what I'm saying, I have children that depends on me and I have to live for them and provide for them. So I'm constantly thinking of ways to better myself and better my life. And there are sometimes goals that I really need to reach and really want to do. And I have to set that in my mind state, like, you know what, April, get motivated. Some things I have to do without, just like I said, fuck a relationship. I got goals and motivations that I don't need to meet. And this is what I'm going to do. Fuck everybody else. It's not even like fuck everybody else, but right now, this is who I want to be and this is what I'm going to do. And I'm not going to allow anybody to stop me from meeting my goals or doing what the fuck I need to do. And that's just how I feel. You know what I'm saying? That is just what I need to do for myself and for my children. And when you have kids, a lot of times they are like your main goal. They are your main motivation. Like, you're going to do no matter what for your kids. And a lot of people are like that. A lot of parents are like that. Then you have some who just don't give a fuck. But for me, being that these are my children and they depend on me and they didn't ask to be here, I'm going to try to reach my goal and be motivated as fuck just because I want them to be better in life. I want them to have whatever they need in life and I want them to surpass what I expect of them in life. You know what I'm saying? I have to be a positive role model for not just myself, but for my children and my grandchildren. And even for those who may watch me, sometimes I might be a positive role model. Just the little things that I do, even though I may come off as harsh to some people with my non-filtered mouth, and the things that I say about certain relationships or certain things in life, that helps a person whether you know it or not. Some people don't take too kindly to soft-spoken words. Some people who have learned to have soft-spoken words, or, you know, you speak softly to them, they don't really adhere to that. They don't really go with the flow. They just kind of like nonchalant with it. But then you have people like myself who are just very blunt and have no filter and come at you with like this rah, rah, rah attitude. That is like a better incentive to some people. That's just what, how some people are able to communicate in life. You know what I'm saying? It just depends on the person. So with me, how do you reach your goal and how do you start your own business? I really can't tell you how to start your own business because people start their own businesses all different types of way. Me, I had a dream when I had my website, well, for my jewelry. And that's what I wanted to do because I loved accessories. And that's what I got into. And I started seeing all these different websites with all these type of crappy ass accessories. Or some of them, were nice accessories, but the website wasn't put together really well. And like, it's like, you know what I'm saying? So I just wanted a piece of the internet. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to be a part of something. And so I really can't tell you how to go about starting a business because everybody's goal and aspects and the way they do things are totally different. You know what I'm saying? Just like we're here on YouTube. It's not really a business for me. This is about life and this is about how I communicate with the world. You know what I'm saying? And yeah, I may get some free shit and at the end of the day, but it was never to become a business for me. It's just my way and my outlet on life. And I think that's how a lot of people started off on YouTube. When you start looking at YouTube as, oh, I want it to be a business, or I want it to be a business, then it's really not going to be a business for you. You have to do it because you like to do it and you enjoy to do it. You know what I'm saying? And it doesn't matter if you get X, Y amount of Z of views or X, Y amount of a check or whatever. You have to do it because you enjoy doing it. If you don't enjoy doing something, then it's really not going to pan out for you and it's not going to work out for you. And yeah, this is like my third channel. And my first channel, you know, which was just plain Muffin Is My Lovers, I got so many different sponsors and there really wasn't too many people in the wig game. It was only a couple of us. So I was getting crazy views and mad endorsements and sponsors and paychecks and just buku shit. Then I had to start my second channel, which was Taken. And then I had to start my third one. So there is perseverance. Obviously, I must enjoy doing YouTube if I started three channels and I worked my way back up to where I started off with. You know what I'm saying? Obviously, it's something that I enjoy doing because had it not been and it was a business, y'all bitches would not see me up on here. You know what I'm saying? I'd be like, fuck all of that. I'm going to just go out to the real world and get a real job and do this and do that. You know what I'm saying? So I enjoy doing YouTube and it's part of my life and you guys are part of my life. So I really can't tell you how to start a business. You have to do your research. You have to be motivated. You have to enjoy something you do. Don't pick a business that you think is going to make money and you don't even like the shit. You know what I'm saying? Just like with wigs, I love hair. It's an accessory to me because I don't feel like I should have to cut and dye my own hair. I want to be who I want to be today, and then tomorrow I want to be somebody fucking different. That's just it. That's just what it is. So I enjoy doing it. Okay, you have to enjoy doing what you need to do. There are many people who open up a business only just because they need the money, and that business ain't worth shit, and they hate it. Do something that you enjoy doing. That's the first thing of opening up any business or starting a business. Make sure it's a business that you want to do. And just like you said about the animals, that's what you, if you love animals and that's what you enjoy doing, then by all means, look at it as something that you want to do and you want to help people, not because of cha-ching. Yeah, it is really nice to always get paid because you got bills to pay too, but at the end of the day, look at it as something you value and you don't mind getting up and putting in that hard work. Now, as for the relationship status, girl, be alone for a minute because that was some hard shit to get over. And I'm sorry, but a nigga would have been dead if it were me. But, you know, it is here nor there. So, yes, you guys, I hope you enjoyed this real talk today. I am sorry about my camera acting foolish. I don't know what the hell. It just started just doing its own crazy thing. I think it needed to be clean. I'm not really sure. I let the little sensors clean it or whatever. And I don't know. Maybe it's the memory card, but listen, this camera is like 5 months old. You know that asshole, he bought it for me, so I still have the receipt though. I will take this motherfucker back to Best Buy and be like, look bitches, this camera was $949, all accessories and shit. Y'all better fix this shit or give me something that work, okay? But yes, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you check out my makeup line, and shit, if you ain't gonna buy all 6 lipsticks, at least buy one. Show your girl some love, because I think I have put in a lot of hard work into this collection. Plus, it's a black-owned business, okay? I might be light-skinned, but we black. And also, the company who I have collaborated with, they are black-owned as well. So it's a black-owned business, black-owned lipsticks. So get these black-owned products on your black-owned lips, okay? But yes, make sure you support my makeup line. Okay, I don't really ask for much. I don't. And yes, you guys, I'm gonna go. Got me some cherry sours. Have you guys ever had these cherry sours? I absolutely love these. This is the Kroger brand. I'm not really a huge fan of the Kroger brand. I do like the Walgreens brand. They're called cherry sours, but Walgreens was out. They're really, really good. And they just look like cherry lemon heads, but they're just cherry. You know what I'm saying? And they're so good. And they're saucy. You can chew them, but they're sour. But really, really good. So yes, if you have a Walgreens, even Walmart has a brand. However, Walgreens brand is still much better. I don't know what it is. And it could be crazy. Like, they could all probably be manufactured in the same company, but they got their own bag. But for some reason, they just taste different. Walgreens tastes better. Even my kids said that. So yes, honeys, yes. Stay deeper and delicious. Make sure you rate, comment, subscribe, share this video, thumbs it up. Check out my website. Oh, not my website, but my lipstick line. And as always, stay deeper and delicious. And I will see you all on the next video.